Hello, friends. I'm Mr. Palumbo, and I'm a social studies teacher. And my fellow teachers and I are here today to talk to you about amusement parks. Most people love an amusement park. In fact, we tend to think of them as a break from everyday life. But did you know that early amusement parks have a lot to do with how communities developed and how people socialized? Amusement parks even played a role in civil rights. We've got really exciting activities for you, from learning about the science and math that make thrill rides so thrilling, to researching the history of amusement parks and discovering how today's massive parks started as open spaces where people could hold picnics and have dances. The oldest operating amusement park in the world is called Bakken. It's located in Klampenborg, Denmark. Believe it or not, Bakken opened in 1583. The park was situated in a large forest that had natural spring water. Since water quality was pretty poor in the big nearby city in those days, people started visiting this park, and soon, entertainers started showing up there to perform for the crowds. Eventually, Bakken became a type of amusement park that we know today. Early amusement parks began appearing in the United States at the time of the Industrial Revolution, from the late 1700s to the early 1800s. People started to have more leisure time, and new technologies in transportation allowed them to travel outside their communities. One of those modes of transportation was the streetcar, or trolley. The first amusement parks in the United States were actually called trolley parks. These trolley parks had picnic and recreation areas that were usually situated at the end of the trolley lines. In fact, it was actually the trolley companies that created and ran these parks because it gave people in the bigger cities a reason to ride the trolleys on the weekends. More riders equaled more money for the trolley companies, so the parks were really a strategic business decision. So if you enjoy amusement parks today, you can thank the trolley system for starting them. Many cities had trolley parks, but none had as many as Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Between the late 1800s and the mid-1950s, Pittsburgh had nearly two dozen trolley parks. The landscape of western Pennsylvania and its thriving industrial scene made Pittsburgh the perfect place for so many trolley parks to be built. Families would load onto the streetcars on the weekend and escape the city for relaxation and recreation at the trolley park. First, there was Luna Park. It was situated near where the University of Pittsburgh stands today. It featured a Ferris wheel, roller coasters, bumper cars, and other rides. And it had a concert stage and dance hall. Another popular trolley park in the region was Westview Park. And in 1910, it offered the first roller coaster in the state to have a dip that dropped over 50 feet. One lesser known amusement park is Fairview Park in Westmoreland County. It has a tremendous amount of significance because it was created in the 1940s by a group of African-American churches. Most trolley parks at the time were segregated. This park gave an alternative to other trolley parks of that era. As the era of overt segregation came to an end in the 1960s, attendance at Fairview Park dropped, and eventually the attractions were torn down. Today, Fairview Park's history still lives on. The Pennsylvania Historical Museum and Commission has deemed it a historical landmark, and in 2011, it was also listed on the National Register of Historic Places. And now, I'd like to talk to you about an amusement park I've gone to my entire life. And maybe some of you have been there as well. It's Kennywood Park, outside Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. The land that became Kennywood started as a farm owned by the Kenny family. It was a popular picnic spot dating all the way back to the Civil War. Then, in 1898, the Monongahela Street Railways Company leased the land from the Kenny family and turned it into a trolley park. Kennywood was designated as a National Historic Landmark in 1987. Who'd have thought that something that was founded in the 19th century would still have such significance in our community today? One of the things Kennywood is known for is its roller coasters. Kennywood has some of the oldest and most interesting roller coasters in the world, and we're going to focus on five of them. I'm going to ask that you study the features of each roller coaster, like what materials were the tracks made of? Were they wooden? Were they steel? You can also consider the design of each coaster. Are there steep dips, inverted loops? What do you think these clues will reveal about how old each coaster is? We'll talk a lot about those coasters. Then, I'd like to know what you found interesting about each coaster, and if you could travel back in time, what you'd like to learn about the history of each one. Amusement parks are fun, but they're also a gathering place for people from diverse backgrounds and cultures. They're also great places for families and friends to make memories. Not to mention the economic benefit to whatever town those amusement parks are situated in. So the next time you're on a merry-go-round, or you're taking a ride on a roller coaster at 75 miles per hour, have fun, but take a moment to appreciate the trolley parks that started it all.
To download the free lesson plans to be used with this program, visit us online at wqed.org/SOS. To request a hard copy of the lesson plans, please contact your local school district. Funding for this program is provided by the Pennsylvania Department of Education for Learning at Home.